The direct feed low activity waste system at Hanford will process radioactive liquid from waste tanks and feed it to a low activity waste melter. The system is designed to filter out any residual solids and remove highly radioactive cesium from the liquid waste or supernatant before it is fed to a melter at the waste treatment and immobilization plant. PNNL is providing scientific and technical support to the Department of Energy and its contractors as they prepare to start pre-treating and immobilizing low-activity waste. We've built a unique capability to test actual tank waste to support the DFLAW mission. The radioactive waste test platform consists of the four main process steps that are analogous to the DFLAW system. The first two are the waste filtration system, which removes solids, and the ion exchange columns, which remove highly radioactive cesium. Together, these two unit operations represent the initial tank-side cesium removal system that will operate during DFLAW processing. The third step is the vitrification process. This includes a melter operating at very high temperatures to melt a mixture of waste and glass-forming chemicals. The molten glass cools and solidifies, locking radioactive materials into the glass structure. The vitrification process was pioneered by researchers at Pacific Northwest National Laboratory in the 1970s. Finally, there is the evaporator, which concentrates the off-gas condensate captured from the vitrification process. The liquid, which retains trace radiological components, is sent back to the melter feed to be vitrified. The radioactive waste test platform was built by PNNL in the Radiochemical Processing Laboratory on the Hanford site. Tank waste samples are transferred to the RPL, where the test platform can be used to troubleshoot and minimize unforeseen processing issues. The radioactive waste test platform has processed radioactive samples from three waste tanks so far. The tests conducted at PNNL have already provided valuable information resulting in modifications to DFLAW design and certain operational parameters. For example, we found that waste temperature is important. The filter will work better during warmer weather, when specific salts will stay dissolved and reduce filter load. But the ion exchange columns will work better in the colder months, when cesium loading capacity is higher. The radioactive waste test platform is the proven ability to discover potential issues ahead of full-scale radioactive operations. Once operations begin, the platform can also be used to rapidly develop innovative solutions to emerging processing challenges. Going forward, PNNL can use the platform to develop and test new technologies or processes that, if deployed, would improve operational efficiency over the baseline flowsheet. Vetting a potential change using the platform prior to full-scale implementation provides critical data to reduce risks. PNNL's experts are here to offer technical and scientific support to DOE and its contractors for the environmental management mission.